In the vast emptiness of space, 93 million miles from Earth, a storm is brewing. But this isn't a hurricane or a tornado. It's something far more powerful and far more dangerous. A solar storm. And experts say it could be coming in 2025. But what does that mean for you? For me? For the world? Imagine a day when the internet simply stops. No emails, no banking, no communication. Chaos. This is not a science fiction, it's a science fact. And it's time to prepare. Throughout history, we've learned that the greatest threats often come from the most unexpected places, the depths of the ocean, the microscopic world, and now the burning heart of our solar system. This isn't a story to frighten you. It's a story to inform you, to open your eyes to a cosmic reality that could change life as we know it. Our sun is a giant nuclear reactor, constantly churning with unimaginable energy. Sometimes the energy escapes. Solar storms, also known as coronal mass ejections or CMEs, are massive bursts of plasma and magnetic fields ejected from the sun's atmosphere. To understand a solar storm, imagine a cannon firing billions of tons of superheated gas into space at millions of kilometers per hour. These ejections aren't rare. They happen all the time, but most miss Earth, harmlessly drifting into the vastness of space. But when one of these storms is aimed directly at us, the results can be both spectacular and catastrophic. The beautiful dancing lights of the aurora borealis, that's one side of the story. But on the darker side, these storms can disrupt satellites, disable GPS, and even cripple electrical grids. Understanding these phenomena is the first step in protecting ourselves. The sun operates on an 11-year cycle of activity. Peaks and valleys of sunspots, solar flares, and geomagnetic storms. Right now, we are climbing toward solar maximum, expected around 2025. But why does this matter? During solar maximum, the frequency and intensity of solar flares and CMEs significantly increase. We've seen this before. Each cycle bringing its own level of risk and beauty. But scientists at NASA and the European Space Agency believe this upcoming cycle, Solar Cycle 25, could be one of the most active in recent memory. This prediction isn't based on guesswork. It's grounded in decades of data. Patterns observed through satellites' imagery, sunspot counts, and magnetic field measurements. And with each cycle, our dependence on technology grows. More satellites, more infrastructure, more vulnerability. The timing couldn't be more critical. we live in a connected world. At the heart of that connection lies the internet. But behind every video call, every online bank transfer, every text message, is a complex web of infrastructure. Undersea fiber optic cables stretch for hundreds of thousands of miles across our oceans. They carry over 95% of all international data traffic. But here's the catch. Those cables are shielded. But their repeaters, the devices that amplify signals, are vulnerable to geomagnetic storms. These repeaters require electricity to function. A powerful solar storm can induce electrical currents in these cables, burning out components, disrupting data transmission, and effectively cutting continents off from one another. And it's not just undersea cables. Satellite networks, power grids, air traffic control, all depend on systems highly susceptible to solar activity. It's easy to take the internet for granted until it's gone. This isn't the first time humanity has faced the wrath of the sun. In 1859, the Carrington event struck Earth, the most powerful solar storm ever recorded. Telegraph lines burst into flames. Operators received electric shocks. Aurora displays lit up the sky as far south as the Caribbean. In 1989, Quebec's power grid collapsed from a geomagnetic storm, leaving millions in the dark for hours. Flights were grounded. Radio communications failed. And that was in a time before smartphones, digital banking, and 24/7 connectivity. Fast forward to today, our modern infrastructure is far more advanced, but also far more fragile. The stakes are exponentially higher. And the sun, it hasn't changed. But we have. Imagine waking up to silence, no internet, no mobile signal. Planes grounded. Financial markets frozen. Hospitals disconnected. Emergency services unable to coordinate. This isn't a Hollywood script. It's a scenario modeled by scientists and cybersecurity experts. They predict that if a Carrington-level event struck today, global internet outages could last weeks or even months. Vulnerable regions, particularly those dependent on undersea cables without proper shielding, could face prolonged blackouts. Supply chains disrupted. Banking halted, even basic communication paralyzed. It's a sobering thought, but it's also a call to action. Thankfully, governments and space agencies are not blind to this threat. NASA's Solar Dynamics Observatory monitors the sun 24/7. the European Space Agency has launched missions like Solar Orbiter to study solar activity up close. Warning systems are improving. Forecasting models are more sophisticated. But infrastructure, that's where the real challenge lies. Power grids, satellite constellations, data centers, undersea cables, all vulnerable unless we take proactive steps. It's not about fear, it's about preparation. And that preparation must happen now, before the storm arrives. So what can you do? First, awareness. Understand the threat. Stay informed about space weather alerts. Second, preparedness. Backup essential data. Have offline copies of critical documents. Keep emergency supplies ready. Encourage local governments and businesses to invest in shielding technologies from hardened satellite components to robust undersea cable protections. Third, demand accountability. Infrastructure providers must prioritize resilience. Policymakers must fund space weather mitigation. And you can be part of the solution through awareness and action. The sun gives us life, warmth, energy. But it can also remind us how fragile modern civilization truly is. The 2025 solar storm may pass without incident, or it may be the greatest technological challenge for our time. Either way, we must be ready. Because the greatest threat is not the storm itself, but our failure to prepare for it. The internet connects us, but nature humbles us. The question remains, will we listen before it's too late? Thanks for watching Orbital Vistas. Stay curious, stay inspired, and keep looking up.